We saw a new generation of guys that were more creative, wanted, you know, more out of life and wanted to create their own identity, and there wasn't a brand out there for them. And we combined that with basically the world stage that the internet gave us.
Hillman Shaw is a pretty unique place in terms of creativity, technology, entrepreneurship, and fashion design. So I think as a company and a brand, we do also represent that. So there's no doubt that we're happy and proud to be here. And I think there's even more that we can do as a community to leverage that even more.
The whole idea of community has always been a big part of our brand. And I think it's a big part of our generation as well. This idea that you want to feel like you're part of a bigger picture. And as we've grown in some ways, Frank and Oak as a brand has become sort of a platform for, you know, guys that are into like entrepreneurship, guys that are into like taking risk and making a difference in today's world. One reason actually why we decided to open local locations basically in different cities, it's to reinforce that aspect of community. And so we do tons of events in our community spaces. That's the reason why we have coffee shops in our spaces. And the idea is to bring the creative community together.
In terms of my favorite Montreal moment, I think it's not one moment, but it's every summer. Once summer arrives in Montreal, it's just like the best place on earth. Like every single night, there's something fun to do, and like there's festivals, there's music, there's culture. It just creates a nice mix in the summer.
We're big Montreal Canadiens fans, so there's no doubt that when you go over there and watch a game, it's something special if you're a sports person. And one thing that, of course, stands out and is a definite must, you just have to try out the poutine over here. It's definitely something that is actually world-renowned, and people want it and eat it. And you know what, we always like to eat a couple of poutines now and again as well. I mean, the food scene in Montreal is actually pretty remarkable, I'd say. The amount of restaurants is, there's a lot of them, lots of variety.
There's almost way too many restaurants for the amount of people that are here, so it's good that, you know, we get some visitors once in a while.
Go on Saint Laurent in Little Italy and walk all the way down to the river. By doing that, you almost see all of Montreal. You know, the Mile End, you see like the more artistic area of Montreal, you see downtown, and you get into the old Montreal, and I find that you just get a good feel of everything that Montreal has to offer.
The one thing is to find someone that is from Montreal and ask them to take you out on a tour of their neighborhoods. And it's the places that you least expected that, you know, bring the greatest pleasures.
It's the first time this year that we're gonna get the chance to speak at C2. We presented, you know, at a place like South by Southwest, and like, but it's great to kind of do it at home. We definitely really respect what the guys at C2 are trying to do in terms of, you know, bringing people into Montreal and like getting that creative energy going.
To start a business, I mean, you can do it anywhere in the world in today's day and age, and Montreal is definitely a great place to do so. I mean, we have lots of creative folks, and there's also actually access to capital and money. I think once you have the faith and courage to go out and do something you really chase and love, then you can do it no matter where, and Montreal is definitely a great place to do so.